Good evening. As we go to where Russian troops are moving through the streets of rebel-held areas of eastern Ukraine on the orders of President Putin. The West has responded with outrage and anxiety. Australia warning it is prepared to issue sanctions against Russia and is pulling our diplomatic officials out of Ukraine.
With the stroke of a pen, a frightening development for Ukraine. President Putin signing a decree recognising the Russian-backed separatist regions of Donetsk and Luhansk as independent. Within hours, he was moving Russian troops into those regions under the guise of peacekeeping. I consider it necessary to take a long overdue decision, he said in a televised address. The move, a major breach of the existing peace agreement and a further threat to eastern Ukraine's fragile front line, which has seen a sharp escalation in violence in recent days.
This is plainly in breach of international law. I think it's a very ill omen and a very dark sign.
International outrage was swift, the US slapping the breakaway regions with an executive order which prevents new American investment, trade or financing, and at an emergency meeting of the UN Security Council, warnings of more sanctions to come.
There will be severe economic consequences to its actions.
Our Prime Minister has vowed Australia will be in lockstep with its allies and follow their lead.
Some suggestion that they're peacekeeping is nonsense. Russia should step back. It should unconditionally withdraw, back behind its own borders, and stop threatening its neighbours.
The diplomatic window is slowly sliding shut. The Kremlin downplaying the possibility of a summit between President Biden and Putin, saying there are no concrete plans. For now, Ukraine is standing firm, its president addressing the nation in the early hours. We are not afraid of anyone and we will not give away anything. Ultimately, it may have no choice, President Putin rejecting even the notion of Ukrainian identity. Saying modern Ukraine was completely created by Russia. US intelligence estimates Russia now has more than 190,000 troops encircling the nation.
Nine Euro correspondent Carrie-Anne Greenbank is in Kiev. Carrie, Australia is taking this escalation extremely seriously.
Well, it is, Pete. Australian diplomats had already been ordered out of Kiev, where we are, to Lviv last week. Now they're being told to get out of Lviv as well. The Australian government saying that they will be working from Poland or Romania. And as we go to air tonight, the UK Prime Minister is chairing an emergency COBRA meeting. Boris Johnson saying he is about to announce significant new sanctions against Moscow, and he is also considering more military support for Ukraine, saying there is a very real possibility of invasion in the coming hours or days. Australia considering sanctions as well. Pete?
Carrie, thank you. We may be far from the conflict, but the events in Russia and Ukraine could soon hit home. Chris O'Keefe is with me in the studio. Chris.
Well, Pete, the question is, what impact would trade sanctions have on us here in Australia? And the most difficult problem immediately will be petrol prices. Taking Russia's oil production out of the market would see oil prices rise over $100 US a barrel for crude oil, which equates to more than $2 a litre consistently for E10 at the pump here in Australia. The next issue will be trade. Now, Australia does very little business with Russia. We do, though, sell grains and live animals, but it is unknown if sanctions will apply to those industries. However, a concern for the Morrison government will be aluminium. Russian company Rusal owns 20% of Queensland company Alumina Limited. That is 1,100 jobs in Gladstone in central Queensland. We also import a decent whack of fertiliser from Russia, which will drive up prices for farmers. So while we're a long way from this conflict, Australia cannot, Peter, escape the global market.